The second generation CALF 3D camera, released this September, recently received some minor updates. The manufacturer had promised these improvements from the beginning, and now a firmware update has arrived, bringing changes to the camera's performance, including image quality. In this review, I'll walk you through the most important updates and show you how to update the firmware on your CALFVISINSE camera. Then showcase the upgrades with sample footage captured after the update. Let's dive in! Let's take a closer look at the update process, as it might not be immediately clear for everyone. Watching how I complete the process should give you more confidence to learn from the upgrade yourself. According to the manufacturer, there are three ways to update the firmware. Automatic update requires your camera to be continuously connected to the internet. At some point, you'll receive a notification about the update. However, staying online all the time isn't practical during shooting, and it's inconvenient to be interrupted with an update message mid-session. That's why I recommend the manual update method. Manual update is the most common method, allowing you to schedule the update when it's convenient, such as before a shoot. While if your camera is running firmware older than version 2.1.2, it's recommended to use the third method. However, as you can see, I will update this camera from one of the first firmware versions successfully with method 2. And for this tutorial, I'll demonstrate the manual update process, which starts with logging into your CALF account and connecting your camera to a Wi-Fi network. Creating an account on your CALF camera is quick and straightforward. Just set a username and password. No email or external platform connections are required. Once logged in, navigate to the About page and tap Check Update. The camera will detect the latest firmware and prompt you to download and install it. Your camera may restart a few times during the process, which is normal. Simply follow the on-screen instructions. When the update is complete, you'll notice a subtle change. The logo screen background will now appear white. After installation, check the firmware version on the About page to confirm the update. If you tap Check Update again, you'll see a message indicating that your camera is up to date. Before you start using the new firmware, I recommend initializing the device. This ensures optimal performance with the updated system. If you can't log in, don't have Wi-Fi access, or want to ensure you're following the official instructions, you can use the third update option. Download the firmware and the installation guide from the CALF website. But now let's dive into the improvements brought by this firmware update. One noticeable improvement is the significantly reduced startup time. The camera powers on much faster than before. But maybe one of the most important changes is that color science has been improved, bringing colors closer to true-to-life tones. This subtle yet impactful change significantly enhances the overall image quality. You'll also find new presets tailored for various shooting environments. These presets allow the camera to adjust settings based on your surroundings. In practice, I believe it should affect the color profiles, but also ISO and shutter speed settings too. And it's very important as there are still no manual setting option during shooting videos. With the previous firmware, some of you might notice artifacts and motion picture tearing, especially when shooting with a moving camera. These issues have now been addressed, making the camera more reliable.
And besides minor changes in color science and all this polishing, perhaps the most exciting update is the addition of new video formats and frame rate options, including higher resolution like 8K. The updated modes offer more flexibility, but now let's see it in practice, in comparison with the third generation CALF 2.
In this comparison, you'll see footage from the first generation on the left and the second generation CALF, recorded after the firmware update on the right. The first generation CALF records in 6K at 50 fps, and with the latest firmware, the second generation CALF now offers the same option. Both videos were recorded at the same resolution and frame rate for a fair comparison. Let's take a closer look. Here's a side-by-side comparison at 100% zoom, so you can clearly see the details in both images. With the firmware update, the second generation CALF also introduces an 8K video option at lower frame rates. Switching to 8K at 24 fps, we can examine the difference in higher resolution. First, here's the same scene recorded in 6K and 8K with the second generation CALF.
And now, let's compare the two cameras side by side again, this time with the second generation recording in 8K. Finally, here's a zoomed in view at 100% showcasing the level of detail you can expect with the updated camera compared to the first generation CALF. This comparison was made in 3D VR 180 mode, but of course, both cameras offer additional recording options. CALF has reverted to video formats similar to those used in their first generation camera, allowing us to shoot in both 3D VR 180 and flat 3D modes. Additionally, we have the option to choose between 2D and 3D modes. However, the real strength of this camera lies in its 3D capabilities, so I would primarily focus on using the 3D options. Here we can choose between 3D flat and 3D VR 180 modes with an additional option called original mode, which excludes the content aware mask. 3D VR 180 mode produces a 3D VR 180 video with two fisheye images side by side. This format is ideal for immersive VR experiences with content aware fill automatically applied to fill the edges of the frame. In 3D original mode, we capture raw footage from the lenses without any fisheye corrections or content aware fills, resulting in black borders around the image. While the third option is shooting in 3D flat mode, 8K resolution is also available, but the video will be cropped and the image will be projected with fisheye correction, creating a flat, side-by-side 3D video. This mode is perfect for viewers who don't have VR headsets but still want to enjoy 3D content using simple accessories like cardboard or VR glasses. However, these videos may not be as enjoyable without these accessories as they are displayed as flat side-by-side images with each frame appearing twice simultaneously. And depending on the shooting mode, we can also adjust the preview. In VR 180 modes, switching to fisheye view gives us a better overall perspective of the entire image, allowing us to ensure there's nothing unwanted at the edges, like our fingers sneaking into the frame while holding the camera. Overall, the flexibility to choose between VR 180 and flat 3D formats allows us to tailor our content to specific needs. And this firmware update represents a significant step forward for the second generation CALF 3D camera, enhancing both usability and creative possibilities. If you enjoyed this quick overview of the update, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to check out my previous in-depth review of the camera for more insights. And for further updates and more creative content and tutorials, subscribe to my channel, and see you next time!